بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. Respected brothers and sisters, wherever you are, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. إن شاء الله within the next week we will be beginning the holy month of Ramadan, the month of fasting, the month of spirituality, the month of turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a month which in it the Quran was revealed in, a month which in it is Laylatul Qadr, which is greater than 1,000 months. For some of us, as we approach the month of Ramadan, we are reminded of the headaches and unable to drink coffee, and the pain in the stomach and the feeling of hunger. While there are others who Ramadan reminds them of the Quran, Ramadan reminds them of spirituality and turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ramadan reminds them of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, whichever category you find yourself in, we need to prepare ourselves for the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan comes and goes every year, and there are some people that benefit from this month, and there are others who allow this month to come and pass without benefiting, without becoming better individuals. Now, how should we prepare for this holy month, for the month of Ramadan? We prepare for this month by filling our fridges, by making sure we have the best food that we're preparing, that we're going to be craving. Now, this is one way that many of us, when we say, I want to get ready for the month of Ramadan, this is one thought that comes to our minds. A lot of people right now, these days, they're saying, I have to go and shop, I have to go and get ready, I have to go and make sure my fridge is full, it's stocked, so that once the month of Ramadan comes, we're going to be able to have the best food, and we're going to be able to feast, and we're going to be able to enjoy ourselves. Now, this is one type of preparation. There's nothing wrong with that. Prepare and enjoy your meal. Enjoy whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ زِينَةَ اللَّهِ The blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as it's halal, you can enjoy it. However, we have to keep in mind that we should not be spending so extravagantly during the month of Ramadan, because it goes against the purpose of this holy month. However, the preparation that I am talking about and that we all need to prepare for is the spiritual preparation. Preparing ourselves to embrace the Quran, preparing ourselves to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, preparing ourselves to recite more dua. This is the preparation that we need. This is what we need to remind ourselves of the virtues of the month of Ramadan and the opportunities that we have that bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this month. And the preparation for the month of Ramadan, in fact, does not begin now, a week before this holy month. The preparation for the month of Ramadan begins 2 months prior to the month of Ramadan. We have the month of Rajab and the month of Sha'ban. These are 2 months that help prepare ourselves spiritually and psychologically to enter into the holy month of Ramadan. Because the month of Ramadan is a big deal, my dear brothers and sisters. The month of Ramadan is a month where in it is a night that is greater than 1,000 months. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alfi shahr. So I have to make sure that by the time I enter the month of Ramadan, I am fulfilling the goal and the purpose of this month. One thing a lot of people fail to realize and understand is that each ibadah, each act of worship that we have, it has a distinct purpose. It has a reason. A lot of us, we deal with our worship, we deal with the ibadat, whether it's prayer, whether it's zakat, whether it's hajj, whether it's salah or psalm, whatever it is, we deal with it as something that we need to check off on the check-off list, and then that's it, we could go and live our lives. But that's not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to worship so that my worship has an impact on my life, so that my worship makes me a better person. And similarly, fasting has a purpose. Fasting has a goal. If I am not prepared for the month of Ramadan, I will not be able to attain the goals of fasting. I will not be able to attain the goals of the holy month of Ramadan. So what is the purpose of fasting, my dear brothers and sisters? The purpose is simple. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. O you people who believe, fasting has become obligatory upon you, just as it was obligatory upon people before you. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you may have taqwa. What is taqwa, my dear brothers and sisters? Taqwa is becoming a better person. Taqwa is controlling yourself in front of sin. Taqwa is controlling your desires. Taqwa is self-improvement. All of these, if you want to summarize them into one meaning, that is taqwa. What is taqwa? Taqwa is God consciousness. Meaning that you realize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is constantly watching you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. And this is why fasting, it makes our actions genuine. Because when you're fasting, you're not doing it for any person. Of course, some people, they cheat when they're fasting. That defeats the purpose of fasting. When you're fasting, no one is going to be monitoring you. You're going to be monitoring yourself. Otherwise, someone could go out and leave the house or go open the fridge and eat or drink something. However, you won't be fasting if you do that. You monitor yourself. And when you are monitoring yourself, this gives you the capability to have stronger self-control. This gives you the ability, and it strengthens that emotion or that feeling that you have of God consciousness, where you realize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always watching you. Not only in the face of sinning, not only when you are praying, but even when you're sitting hungry, even when you're laying down on the couch, on your bed, whatever it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. And that pain in the stomach, that feeling of hunger, that's a reminder of that. That's a reminder that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. Now, in order to understand the magnitude of this holy month, first of all, we look at the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The greatest miracle in Islam, the greatest miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi was the Quran itself. It was revealed in the month of Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. And another important feature of the month of Ramadan is that within it is Laylatul Qadr, the night of power or the night of destiny. Laylatul Qadr خير من ألف شهر. And of course, we go and we look at the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and this is a very beautiful sermon of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, in which he welcomes the month of Ramadan. And this is a hadith that is narrated from Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. He says that a few days before the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi stood And he began to introduce the holy month of Ramadan to the Muslims. So Rasulullah says, أيها الناس, O people, إنه قد أقبل عليكم شهر الله. O people, what is approaching you is شهر الله, the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بالبركة, with blessings, والرحمة والمغفرة, and mercy and forgiveness. شهر هو عند الله أفضل الشهور. A month that in the eyes of Allah is the greatest month. Now here Rasulullah says, إِنَّهُ قَدْ أَقْبَلَ إِلَيْكُمْ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ. The month of Allah is approaching you. Now I have to ask myself, how do I approach the month of Ramadan? And how does the month of Ramadan approach me? It approaches me with mercy and blessing and forgiveness while I am thinking of my stomach, while I'm thinking of my headaches, while I'm thinking of dealing with hunger, and I'm thinking of it as a burden upon me. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi tells us that the month of Ramadan is a month of blessing, a month of mercy, a month of forgiveness. شَهْرٌ هُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَفْضَلُ الشُّهُورِ. Out of all of the months, the month of Ramadan is the greatest of months. وَأَيَّامُهُ أَفْضَلُ الْأَيَّامِ, and its days are the best of days. وَلَيَالِيهِ أَفْضَلُ الْلَيَالِي, and its nights are the best of nights. وَسَاعَاتُهُ أَفْضَلُ السَّاعَاتِ, and its hours are the best of hours. هو شهر دعيتم فيه إلى ضيافة الله وجعلتم فيه من أهل كرامة الله. It is a month that you are invited as the guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the host and you are the guest. Now, if you go to a friend's house, someone who loves you, you go to their house, of course not during the time of quarantine, but you go to their house at a different time, they're going to welcome you, they're going to honor you, they're going to bring out the best food, they're going to do whatever they can to show that they are honoring you. Now imagine if that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that's honoring you. Allah is the most generous. Allah is the most capable. Allah is the one who his bounties do not finish. So Rasulullah says, هُوَ شَهْرٌ دُعِيتُمْ فِيهِ إِلَىٰ ضِيَافَةِ اللَّهِ وَجُعِلْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ أَهْلِ كَرَامَةِ اللَّهِ. Not only are you the guests of Allah, but you are the distinguished guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the ones who Allah wants to honor. Sometimes you have guests and sometimes you have a distinguished guest. Sometimes you have a guest that you're honoring this person. The month of Ramadan, we are the honored guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you are the honored guest, how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treat you? Allah will treat you by rewarding you, by giving you the opportunity to be rewarded in any way possible. Even something as simple as breathing. You don't need to say the dhikr, you don't need to do dua, you don't need to be praying, you don't need to be doing anything. As long as you're not disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while you are breathing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the reward of someone who's doing tasbih, someone who's glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أنفاسكم فيه تسبيح. Your nafas, your breathing is a type of tasbih. ونومكم فيه عبادة. And even while you're sleeping, that is considered a type of worship. The only time I don't feel too guilty when I'm sleeping is during the month of Ramadan. Because if you're tired, if you're sleeping, then that's a time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will consider as a ibadah. So of course, if you're going to spend your whole month in sleep, like some people, that is also something that you will regret. Because imagine if the reward of Allah for sleeping is this much, then what is the reward of someone who's actually praying, who's actually reciting the Quran, who's actually doing things? I know some people who set up, you know, they turn on their alarm clock to wake them up so that they could read the Quran, so that they could recite the Quran, so that they could recite the dua. Because even though Allah is rewarding you while you are sleeping, the reward while you are worshiping is multiplied many times more. وَعَمَلُكُمْ فِيهِ مَقْبُولٌ. Your actions are accepted. وَدُعَاءُكُمْ فِيهِ مُسْتَجَابٌ. And your dua, your supplications, are answered. فَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ رَبَّكُمْ بِنِيَّاتٍ صَادِقَةٍ وَقُلُوبٍ طَاهِرَةٍ أَن يُوَفِّقَكُمْ لِصِيَامِهِ وَتِلَاوَةَ كِتَابِهِ. So ask Allah, and this is when we have to ask Allah. Ask Allah now. Ask Allah, فَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ رَبَّكُمْ بِنِيَّاتٍ صَادِقَةٍ, with pure intentions, وَقُلُوبٍ طَاهِرَةٍ, and with pure hearts, أَن يُوَفِّقَكُمْ لِصِيَامِهِ وَتِلَاوَةَ كِتَابِهِ. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the tawfiq, gives you the blessing of fasting and reciting the Quran. Some people today, they're saying, we're in an era of coronavirus, and I don't know if it's healthy, I don't know if it's safe for me. Now, of course, this is a different issue. And our scholars, including Sayyid Sistani and other scholars, they say that if a person's life is truly in danger, meaning that if you fast, you're going to get sick, or your sickness is going to become worse, or you're going to get sick even after you break the fast later on as a result of fasting, then fasting is not wajib upon you. Because Allah says in the Quran clearly, مَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعُدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. Whoever is sick or traveling, then you could make it up another day. However, my dear brothers and sisters, making it up on another day, the reward is not going to be like the reward of the month of Ramadan. This is why some people, they're looking for ways out of fasting, while Rasulullah is telling us to ask Allah to give us an opportunity to be able to fast the whole month. To be able to fast the whole month. فَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهِ. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with pure hearts, and يُوَفِّقَكُمْ, to give you the tawfiq, لِصِيَامِهِ وَتِلَاوَةِ كِتَابِهِ. There are some people that do not have the tawfiq. They do not have the blessing to be able to fast because they're sick. Of course, if you're sick, it's not obligatory upon you anymore. But this is a great act of worship. وَتِلَاوَةَ كِتَابِهِ. And ask Allah to give you the opportunity to be able to recite the Qur'an during the holy month of Ramadan, because the month of Ramadan is the season of the Qur'an. Of course, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he goes on and he reminds us of the main reasons why fasting is important. And that is so that you think of those who are in need. You think of those who do not have. And my dear brothers and sisters, now during the era of quarantine and this virus, this is a reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us to think of those who are trapped in their homes. This is a reminder for us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to think of those who they're feeling that their life is in danger, that they're at risk of getting sick, they're at risk of harm. These, if you have a house, if you have a roof over your head, if you have your family, if you have your children with you, your spouse with you, if you have food, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember your blessings, because there are a lot of people that do not have. And the month of Ramadan is the season, it is the time for us to remember those who do not have. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he says, وَتَصَدَّقُوا عَلَىٰ فُقَرَائِكُمْ وَمَسَاكِينِكُمْ. During the month of Ramadan, give sadaqah to the ones who are poor and those who do not have. Give to those who do not have. There are some people, they are waiting for other people to give them. They're waiting for the rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَصَدَّقُوا عَلَىٰ فُقَرَائِكُمْ وَمَسَاكِينِكُمْ وَوَقِّرُوا كِبَارَكُمْ. And have respect for the elderly. وَارْحَمُوا صِغَارَكُمْ. And have mercy towards the young. وَصِلُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ. And be connected with your relatives, with your near kin. وَاحْفَظُوا أَلْسِنَتَكُمْ. And control your tongues. My dear brothers and sisters, now during this era, everyone is home. the husband and the wife and the children. You have to work from home. You have to do everything at home. So this naturally will cause some friction in some families. In other families, it will show the true love in that family. And in other families, it shows some friction. This is why right now, the levels of abuse within families and households has also gone up. Because some people, they say, I can't bear being with this person. They lose their patience with other people. The month of Ramadan is going to be an added test to that. Because the month of Ramadan, you're going to be hungry. Some people, when they're hungry, right away they start yelling and they want to blame any person that comes in their way. Rasulullah reminds us. Rasulullah says, وَرْحَمْ وَوَقِّرُوا كِبَارَكُمْ. Have respect for the elderly. Maybe the elderly, they need extra help and attention. Give them that attention that they need. وَرْحَمُوا صِغَارَكُمْ. Have mercy on the children. Maybe you're fasting. You're going to get a headache. Maybe you might hear the children running around. You might hear the children doing things that might annoy you. Remember to have mercy. Remember to have mercy. وَصِلُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ. Be connected with your relatives. وَحْفَظُوا أَلْسِنَتَكُمْ. Control your tongue. Some of us, when we're irritated, when we're angry, we start saying things that we would not say in a normal time. We have to constantly remind ourselves. And this is what God consciousness does. If you are God conscious, you're going to remind yourself to have self-control. وَغُضُّوا عَمَّا لَا يَحِلُّ النَّظَرْ إِلَيْهِ أَبْصَارَكُمْ. And control your eyes. وَعَمَّا لَا يَحَلُّ الْإِسْتِمَاعُ إِلَيْهِ أَسْمَاعَكُمْ. Try to control your ears. Here, a lot of people when they're home, Netflix is playing 24 hours. The PlayStation, the Xbox. People are trying to keep themselves busy with movies, with this and that. Yes, I know sometimes you want to kill time, you get bored, you can't go out. However, the month of Ramadan, it's not haram. A lot of people were asking, is it haram to, you know, watch a movie? Is it haram to do something? No, it's not haram. But you have to think of the month of Ramadan as an opportunity that is going by and it's going to fly by very quickly. So do you want to waste that moment? Do you want to waste those beautiful moments? Because they're going to fly by very quickly. So this is why be very careful. Do not look at the haram and do not listen to the haram. وَعَمَّا لَا يَحَلُّ الْإِسْتِمَاعُ إِلَيْهِ أَسْمَاعَكُمْ وَتَحَنَّنُ. Once again, Rasulullah goes back to those who are needy, specifically the orphans. وَتَحَنَّنُوا عَلَىٰ أَيْتَامِ النَّاسِ. يُتَحَنَّنْ عَلَىٰ أَيْتَامِكُمْ. Have mercy on the orphans of the others. Those who have lost their parents, so Allah will send someone to have mercy on your orphans. These days you don't know. Who knows, can I guarantee that I'm going to be alive for the next month? Can I guarantee that I'm going to be around next year? There is no guarantee. So if there is no guarantee, then I should treat the orphans just as I treat my own children. Because maybe one day, someone will have to come and treat my children in that way. Rasulullah says, وَتَحَنَّنُوا. Show love and compassion. عَلَىٰ أَيْتَامِ النَّاسِ. يُتَحَنَّنْ عَلَىٰ أَيْتَامِكُمْ. Of course, Rasulullah continues and talks about the virtues of this holy month. تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ وَارْفَعُوا أَيْدِيَكُمْ بِالدُّعَاءِ. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Satans, the shayateen are held together. Of course, one of the other blessings of the month of Ramadan, one of the, we spiritually we should be ready, and also socially we should be ready. Because the month of Ramadan is a month that we have to have several goals that we have to meet. One is the spiritual goal. This is at an individual level. You sit and you do your ibadah, you do your salah, you do your dua, your Quran, whatever it is. But also, Islam is a social religion, and the month of Ramadan is a month of socializing. It's a month of caring for other people. Just because you're at home during this era, during this time, you're quarantined at home, doesn't mean that you can't help out other people. You could call other people. You could feed other people. You could make a donation online. You could help out organizations. You could help out institutions. Your local organizations and institutions, they need the help, especially during the month of Ramadan. And this is why Rasulullah says, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ مَنْ فَطَّرَ مِنْكُمْ صَائِمًا مُؤْمِنًا فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ كَانَ لَهُ بِذَٰلِكَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عِتْقُ نَسَمَةٍ. O people, whoever breaks the fast of the sa'im, of the fasting mu'min during this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give this person the reward of the person who has freed a slave in the way of Allah. And then, that's not enough. وَمَغْفِرَةٌ لِمَا مَضَى مِنْ ذُنُوبِهِ. And Allah will forgive your past sins. So here, some of the Muslims, they come and they say, Ya Rasulallah, قِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Amir al-Mu'mineen is narrating this. قِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ فَلَيْسَ كُلُّنَا يَقْدِرُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. Not everyone is able, is financially capable of feeding other people. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi says, اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة اتقوا النار ولو بشربة من ماء. Go further away from the hellfire, even from by even feeding a person a small date, a piece of date, or a cup of water. That's all that you have to do. A piece of date or a cup of water. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. Because in the eyes of Allah, it's not about quantity. In the eyes of Allah, it's about the quality of your action, the quality of your sadaqah, the quality of your charity. The Ahlul Bayt alayhum salam, they gave a piece of bread, a loaf of bread they gave to the poor, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eternalized their action. For anyone who reads the Quran, they have to read that story. وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. It wasn't the quantity, it was the quality. So let us put quality into our ibadah. Let us put quality into our action. And this is what Ramadan, this is what the month of Ramadan does for us during these days. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to prepare us, to prepare us for the month of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us be ready. We have to have self-control. Rasulullah says, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ مَنْ حَسَّنَ مِنْكُمْ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ خُلُقَهُ كَانَ لَهُ جَوَازًا عَلَى الصِّرَاطِ يَوْمَ تَزِلُّ فِيهِ الْأَقْدَامِ. If during this month you controlled your anger and your emotions with other people, and the way that you deal with other people, this will be a passport that will help you pass over the sirat, the bridge, on the day of judgment, the day that people fall and they trip over that bridge. وَمَنْ خَفَّفَ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرَ عَمَّا مَلَكَتْ يَمِينُهُ خَفَّفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ حِسَابَهُ وَمَنْ كَفَّ فِيهِ شَرُّهُ كَفَّ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ غَضَبَهُ يَوْمَ يَلْقَاهُ. If you have people under you, if you have people working for you, try to go easy on them. Don't be so difficult with them. And lessen your burden and the evil that you may have towards other people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove His wrath and His anger on the day of judgment. Of course, Rasulullah continues, he says, the gates of heaven, إن أبواب الجنان في هذا الشهر مفتحة فاسألوا الله ربكم أن لا يغلقها عنكم وأبواب النيران مغلقة. The gates of heaven are open and the gates of the hellfire are closed. After Rasulullah finished, Amir al-Mu'mineen, he stood and he asked Rasulullah, what is the best thing that a person can do during this month? This is a very important question. And I will conclude with this. What is the best deed that any person can do during the month of Ramadan? Is it praying Salat al-Layl? Is it reciting Dua Abu Hamza? Is it reciting Dua al-Iftitah? What is the best thing that a person can do? Rasulullah tells Amir al-Mu'mineen, the best thing that any single one of us can do is al-wara' an maharim Allah. What does that mean? That means making sure you do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not disobeying Allah is an act of worship. You don't need to go and do things. All that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you is to not disobey, and Allah will reward you. That is the best thing that a person can do. So how do you do that? You control your eyes, you control your ears, you control your mouth, what you say, what you gossip, what you talk about. And if you do that, then you will find yourself focusing more on ibadah, and you will start to enjoy the ibadah more. You will start to enjoy the worship and the closeness to Allah more. So with that, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to prepare us for the holy month of Ramadan. نسألك اللهم وندعوك باسمك العظيم الأعظم الأعز الأجل الأكرم يا الله يا الله يا رحمن يا رحيم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات إنك مجيب الدعوات إنك غافر الخطيئات إنك على كل شيء قدير وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات نهدي ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلوات اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.